Welcome to a lesson on how to determine the distance between a plane and a point not on the plane. The distance between a plane and a point Q not on the plane is equal to the magnitude of the projection of vector PQ onto the normal vector n. Remember, this is equal to the absolute value of vector PQ dotted with the normal vector divided by the magnitude of the normal vector, where P is a point in the plane. And again, vector n is a normal vector. One thing we do have to remember is to determine the vector PQ, we will have to determine at least one point on the plane. Let's take a look at why this formula works. Here we have a plane in blue, and the gray vector here is our normal vector. Point P is a point on the plane, and point Q is the point not on the plane. We want to determine the distance from point Q to the plane, or this distance here, which I've labeled D. Remember when we talked about projections of vectors, if we project vector PQ onto the normal vector, we'll have this vector here. The magnitude or length of this projection will be the same as the distance D, or the distance from point Q to the plane. So let's take a look at an example how we can apply this formula. Here we want to determine the distance between the given plane and this point 7, negative 3, 9 that's not on the plane. So we need to find the component form of the normal vector as well as the component form of vector PQ, where P is a point on the plane and Q is the given point. Let's start with the normal vector. Remember when we talked about the equation of a plane, the coefficients of the x, y, and z terms give us the component form of the normal vector. So since the coefficient of the x term is 1, the coefficient of the y term is negative 2, and the coefficient of the z term is positive 3, the normal vector will be the vector with components 1, negative 2, and positive 3. Now we need to find the component form of vector PQ. Remember, P must be a point on the plane, and we're not given a point on the plane, so we do need to find one point on this plane. So for point P, if we let x equal 0 and y equals 0, we would have the equation 3z equals 6, which means the z-coordinate must be 2. So we'll use this point as the point on the plane. Of course, we could use any point, but this one's convenient. And then point Q will be the given point 7, negative 3, 9. So now we need to determine the component form of vector PQ. That'll be 7 minus 0, negative 3 minus 0, and 9 minus 2. Now we have all the information we need to determine the distance given by the absolute value of the dot product of the two vectors divided by the magnitude of vector n. So let's go ahead and figure out what that would be. So we're going to find the absolute value of vector PQ dotted with vector n. So we'll have 1 times 7, that'll be 7, plus negative 2 times negative 3, that's 6, plus 3 times 7, that's 21, divided by the magnitude of vector n, that'll be the square root of 1 squared plus negative 2 squared plus 3 squared. So the numerator will be positive 34. Denominator is going to be the square root of 1 plus 4 plus 9. That's a square root of 14. So this will be the distance between the point 7, negative 3, 9, and the given plane. We may want to convert this to a decimal. This distance will be approximately 9.09 units. And this is how we can determine the distance between a plane and any point not on the plane. The two most important things to remember is that the coefficients of the x, y, and z terms give us the component form of the normal vector. And secondly, we do have to determine one point on the plane on our own, and it's very convenient usually to let x and y equal 0 and then determine what z would have to be to satisfy the given equation of the plane. I hope you found this helpful.